Hi, folks. My name is Tom Peterson here at the RV Corral in Eugene. A beautiful day, and it's a great time to get out and explore this beautiful country of ours. We do have for us today 2013 Pleasureway, Class B camper van. It's got a 6-liter V8 from the Chevrolet chassis, which is kind of a little bit more unique out there to find. You see more Dodges and stuff out there in the camper van in this market. But this is a really nice Chevrolet chassis. It's got a longer wheelbase, so it rides incredibly nice. And it is fully self-contained, so you'll be able to enjoy that. It's a Pleasureway, and it's called a Lexer, and it does have that power sofa in the back, so I'll show you some of those features on the inside. And again, that easy access to the bathroom where you can shut the door, kind of squeeze in there and be able to kind of have use of the restroom without being in the way. Like some of the other camper vans in the past, you'd have to open up the bathroom with both doors. And then you kind of block away the front from the rear, so it kind of makes it closed off. So it makes it nice the way that Pleasureway does theirs. Also Corian and the finishes, they use a really nice custom-made van conversion. But on the outside here, you see it's got that silver metallic. It does have custom aluminum wheels, a little bug shield on the front. You do have a nice big patio awning. That will be one that you do crank out by hand on the corner over there, but it's an easy, like, long rod it comes with. Makes it very easy and comfortable to open up the awning from for most anybody. You do have a little bit of storage. This one here is gonna be a slide tray for that house battery, and that will slide out. Does have really nice tire tread on there. Michelin tires. Custom windows on there that will open up in the rain so you can still get flow, airflow, without having any water in there. These doors will swing out like you see here. Also in the back, you notice that the air conditioner is kind of hidden in there. So from a distance, it still looks like just a van conversion. So a lot of times folks can get these and park them in their community where they live and their driveway and all that, not really have any issues, because it still really looks like just a van conversion as opposed to a fully self-contained motorhome. You do have another nice feature too I like this year, is that they hung the spare tire on that side door here, and it makes it very easy to still get access completely to the inside of your little home here. You have a little bit of storage back over here. The seat belts are nice too, because when you're in there, I'll show you, this sofa goes back up and they have nice shoulder harness seat belts in the back for those passengers. I think if you wanted to invest in a lap belt for like a middle, you can actually then haul three plus the two up front. So it makes it kind of nice if you did have to have more people. Does have a receiver hitch. And tow ratings are probably going to be in that area of 5,000. With that 6-liter V8, so you should be in good shape there for towing. This just kind of gives you an your opportunity to kind of have your sewer hose storage, and then your power supply, your cable, and your city water hookup. Again, everything's really custom fit and put into. You have do an outside shower here, and this shows you easy access to your black and gray valves. A little bit of storage there. Camper vans, you know, they're a van conversion, so you can't put tons of outside storage, but you do have a bit here that they custom put into that with the custom fiberglass, lower panels that they put along that to make it look finished. It's very custom, it's very attractive looking. Also, if the camera kind of looks up, you can see there's a couple windows there we'll show you on the inside as well. Makes it nice for some extra light. But that fiberglass top that you see up here is one piece, so it makes it nice and solid up there, all custom painted. But you also, you know, have that extra height in there. So again, if you're 6'3", you're not gonna fit in there. But I mean, if you're gonna have somewhere around that 6 foot or so, you're pretty comfortable standing inside this little camper van. I'll go ahead and show you, first of all, what it's like in the inside with this sofa up. And then of course you'll be able to see the rest of the video when it's down, so you kind of get an idea how it is. But this is how it's going to be in the back of this with the windows all around me. It does have a little flip up counter that comes up here, so you'll be able to have extra counter space in the kitchen there. but it's very comfortable, memory foam. Again, the seat belts like this being outbound makes it really nice and all that for the passengers to be transporting. And you can also, they can kind of put their feet up, and this back also can be sort of reclined a little bit in multiple positions. So you can kind of work that to where if somebody is traveling with you, you can go ahead and have them kind of lounge back a little bit, put their feet up, you know, maybe take their shoes off and all that, because it's a nice lighter ivory color. You know, they can get a lot of comfortability back here from if you're traveling with other people, or if you just one of the two of you want to come back here and relax, maybe even watch a little television or DVD movie while you're traveling down the road, you'll have all the power you need. So with the rest of it, we'll go ahead and show you the video on the inside with that in that flat position. When we're in the inside, we'll kind of start in the back here, and we'll kind of work our way around. But when you look up above my head here in the back, you do have an air conditioning, which would be able to also produce a little bit of heat and air conditioning, I believe. As a matter of fact, I will double check on that. So if you have any questions at the end of this video, contact me direct on my cell phone. I can tell you lots of things about it that maybe aren't covered in the brief video. It's 541-521-3642, Tom Peterson, and you can reach me right direct that way. This sofa here has a nice memory foam on the first inch and a half, I believe, so it makes it very, very nice for when you're gonna use it for a sleeper. And then for a sofa, it just powers back up in position. And you know, you can see you've got storage that's gonna be up over on this side, and you're gonna see it back here as well. You've got that storage. And then there's also gonna be some storage here. I don't know if the camera guy can capture that, but I tell you, we'll probably capture some of this stuff on the way back. I'll switch positions, but right now in this area you've got sitting and dining if you need to. When I power that back up into the up position there, let's make sure I do that if I have enough battery power. Let's see if I did do that right. So I may not have. Yeah, I think the battery, I have to get it down. I think I put that. Maybe the battery's a little bit low for it. Yeah, so we'll show that in the up position here after a bit. But you have a television that you can see. So when you are lying in bed, you have a nice big Samsung television screen here. And that can flip around so that you can see it from the two seats that I've moved around up front there. So when you are camping, you can kind of sit up there and have dine lap food. And then you can be watching television from there as well, too. So the windows, again, they crank open down there. You have a little bit of ventilation on those back windows. And then you have the side crank windows here as well too. So let me make sure, I think that's, yep. You can see drawers here, you'll see, and a little covered storage space. So perhaps the camera guy can capture that. And then you've got Corian counters, your stainless steel drop sink there, and then your two burner stove. I got a nice little backsplash over here. Makes it real nice for easy cleanup as well too, and safety. You do have a player here for DVDs, a little microwave built in, and a power fan above my head here as well too. So you've got that can really extract the air and exchange the air out of here quite well. So we'll show you these upper cap covered space there. And then what we'll do is we'll switch positions, let the camera guy kind of get at the other end over here. Refrigerator, of course, I will show you, at least that does have that. You know, refrigerator, you can work from I believe it's going to be gas electric at least anyway, and it might even be three-way. Those are questions we can research. I'll just change positions here so we can kind of get a position. I can be able to show you a little bit in that bathroom. Makes it nice to have, for you've got that all contained in there. Little shelving and your little window on the outside, a little sink inside. A lot of camper vans don't even have a sink inside that restroom area, so people like that area to be able to wash up afterwards. You still have your sink up in the kitchen area. As far as easy access on the controls up here, you have your monitor panel, you have start for your generator. It's got about 81 hours on it at this point in time. You've got a light switch in here. You've got also for your hot water heater. A little bit of storage you see on this side, as well as over on this other portion here for soft items, and a little bit here for some maps and things as well. If I open up this, you can see with a little more storage in here behind the driver's seat. You have the furnace, which is down low there for your heating. Again, fully self-contained generator, push-button generator. It's gonna be gasoline generator that you can start from in here, and you do have your shower, your hot water, all the goodies. And these seats up here, being able to rotate them around like this makes it nice, again, if you pull that TV around, to be able to sit here and enjoy that, you know, in your, it's a camper van, so it's gonna be petite, so you have that opportunity to go almost anywhere you wanna go in the country. It makes it very nice. Narrow roads, long cross country, fuel efficiency is in the range of probably 12-ish range as far as miles per gallon with this nice powerful V8 motor. You know, really excellent for, you know, acceleration and getting on and off freeways and what have you, and passing people if you need to. So, you'll have questions at the end of this video. Give me a call direct on my cell phone. It's Tom Peterson, 541-521-3642. And we will be able to, you know, cover anything that wasn't able to be noticed in this video. So let me know and give me a call direct if you need any more questions answered. Thank you much.